Folks, I have a great guest. Jay Schabacker has an incredible background and a wealth of knowledge that he brings to the table in his brand new book called Scientific Challenges to Evolutionary Theory. It's got a subtitle, and How These Challenges Affect Religion. I think it's a very timely book. It's an interesting topic of discussion and some great things that we need to talk about here on the show. Jay, thanks for being with us.
My pleasure.
Jay, before we get into the book too much, let's talk about your background a little bit. You've done a lot of different things in the course of your life. So give me an idea of who you are and how your career's varied, how you ended up getting to this point.
Well, I have been bumping along for 84 years. And so there's a lot of things that I've been doing, including is forming an investment firm, investment newsletter, actually in aerospace work. Got me started in 1958, graduating from Cornell. That was the time of the Sputnik, the Cold War and everything. And every mechanical engineer that graduated from a college got right into aerospace. And I did also. So this was in 1958, start of aerospace activity. And I actually worked on the Titan underground launchers as an engineer. I worked in on the Douglas S-4B stage of the Apollo moon project. That was in California. And then eventually I went down to Texas, down to the Manned Spacecraft Center, Houston, Texas, working for General Electric. That was a fantastic opportunity. There was a lot going on, as you know. I was working on ground support equipment. It's very important for the safety of the site and all that activity. I actually watched the John F. Kennedy car all the way up from Houston to Houston, where he was going to fly to Dallas, Texas. And this was in November 21st, 1963, watching wow. Him going up to Houston before his air flight. And we watched it. The GE guys loved it. Sadly, Kennedy didn't get to see the Apollo landing on the moon. And later on, when the astronauts landed on the moon, it was a very poignant comment put on Kennedy's grave site by somebody, and that was, "Mr. President, the eagle has landed." So that was a time of my career when engineering was a major activity, number of years that I was doing that. I'm an engineer, I'm a researcher, and we went on from there. I actually went to Washington, D.C., ended up in aerospace again, ended up starting an investment firm, and eventually moved to Lexington, South Carolina, retired, active in church, Sunday school activities. Every word of the Bible is meaningful to me. And so I meant to tell people about that, and I meant to tell people about creation in Sunday school classes and all that. And so it's a wonderful group of careers for me, and the most recent career is actually researching and writing some recent books, Purposeful Design, Understanding the Creation was my first book, and this one is Scientific Challenges to Evolutionary Theory, How These Challenges Affect Religion. So it's very active.
We'll put links there so folks, you can get that on Amazon and obviously his website more directly, the Scientific Challenges to Evolutionary Theory.com, and you can get a copy of Jay's book for yourself. And what an incredible journey to go from engineering and researcher through a time working towards the Apollo moon program, and then obviously coming through investments, and obviously your faith has kind of driven you in these later years to pen such a different kind of book than what some people might expect.